What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. When it comes to graph traversal, there are two main techniques that will immediately come to your mind: breadth first search and depth first search. Today we are going to detail and implement the breadth first search algorithm, and in the next video of this series we will go over the depth first search one. Before kicking it off, I want to mention that if you need a refresher or an introduction to what graphs are in general, you can check out our Graphs Fundamentals video linked down below in the description. Now let's get to it. So, traversing a graph is visiting every vertex and edge once in a well-defined manner, which means that while using the breadth first search algorithm, or BFS, you must ensure that each vertex of the graph is visited exactly once. To make use of the BFS algorithm, you must pick a starting vertex, which is usually, and in most cases, what you may consider as the root node of the graph. Now, what BFS does is, given a vertex, it proceeds by exploring all of its neighbors before moving on to the vertices at the next depth level. To shed some light on this definition, let's take this graph as an example and try to traverse it using the breadth first search algorithm. First, keep in mind that BFS groups the vertices of a given graph into two categories, visited and not visited. This will allow the algorithm to traverse each vertex only once. At the beginning, all of our vertices are marked as not visited, and the traversal begins upon picking a starting vertex and marking it as visited. The next thing we need to do is visit the neighbors of the starting vertex we just visited. These vertices are considered to be the first level of this graph, as only one edge separates them from the starting vertex we chose. Then, the same process is repeated on every single neighbor individually. In this example, vertices 3 and 4 will come first, as two edges separate them from our starting vertex. Then finally, vertex 2 is the last to be traversed. Now, notice the order and way in which these vertices were traversed. As soon as a vertex is discovered, it is marked as visited. The starting vertex at first, then its neighbors, then the neighbors of its first neighbor, its second neighbor, and so on. And if you think that this is somewhat similar to the first-in, first-out structure of a queue, you are totally right. You see, implementation-wise, when a vertex is discovered, it should be added to a queue, and only when this queue is empty, the graph is deemed as traversed. Let's go ahead and traverse this same graph again while trying to make use of the queue we just talked about. So, the first thing we need to do is add the starting vertex to this queue. Then, because the queue isn't empty now, we pull the top vertex from it, mark it as visited, and add the neighbors of the vertex we just pulled to the queue. Now, these three actions, pulling from the queue, marking what we pulled as visited, and adding the neighbors of non-visited vertices to the queue, are repeated until the queue is empty and the graph is considered traversed. Let's go ahead now and try to implement the breadth first search algorithm together. As usual, such implementations always begin by creating the node or vertex class. This class will store the data, a Boolean field to keep track of whether this vertex was visited or not, and a list of its neighbor vertices. As usual, we also made sure that our class is generic enough. This will allow us to store any kind of object in the graph. The annotations you see are Lombok annotations that will generate setters, getters, a toString method, and many more. If you have no idea what these are, feel free to take a look at our Lombok annotations video, linked down below in the description. Now on to the breadth first search class. This class should store at the very least the starting vertex from which the traversal will begin. In this implementation, we are going to pass this vertex to the constructor upon initialization of the BFS object. Okay, with all of this out of the way, let's implement the traverse method. In our previous example, we started by adding the starting vertex to the queue we had, and that is exactly what we are going to do here. First, we create the queue in question, and then we add the vertex passed by the user to the queue. Now, while the queue we just created isn't empty, we have to pull or remove the top element or vertex of this queue. Then, as soon as this element is pulled, we mark it as visited, we print it out to do whatever we want to do with it, then finally we have to add all of its neighbors to the same queue to allow the while loop to repeat the same logic on all these vertices. Now, while this implementation may work on a few graphs, it won't work on all of them, as it is missing a crucial part, which I actually hinted at, and it is cycles. Take the same graph we had as an example. If we apply the current implementation on this graph, what will happen is that these two vertices will keep on adding each other to the queue endlessly, triggering an infinite while loop. To fix this, and as I previously mentioned, we need to execute this logic and add to the queue the neighbors of non-visited vertices only. This was done here using the if statement you see in front of you. With this, the implementation of the breadth-first search algorithm is now complete. Let's go ahead and test the code we just wrote using the example we had at the beginning of the video. To do this, I started by creating the 7 vertices we used and stored inside each one the corresponding data integer we had. The next thing I did was set or specify the neighbors of each vertex, which are similar to the graph you see in front of you. Now, when we initialize a BFS object, provide it with a starting vertex, and call the traverse method on it, the output of the breadth first traversal will be as expected. The starting vertex will be outputted at first, followed by its neighbors, then the neighbors of its neighbors, in order, and so on. So, that's it for this video. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.